there, me bro. I'm Nkosi from South Africa, and I am a member of the Tussock Jumper family. The red jumper is our sign of the finest quality, so you can enjoy our authentic taste. Lekker! Italian food like prawn risotto or scallops with a creamy pasta or salad are kiff with me. Open me up and you will smell my tropical guava flavors straight away. I am a bifoc example of rich and ripe style of Chenin Blanc.
Hey everybody, this is Root with Wine on the Dime, and as you saw from the intro, today I'm reviewing a Chenin Blanc and another wine from Tussock Jumper. This is the 2020 South African Chenin Blanc from Tussock Jumper. It is 13% alcohol, and I don't know the price because they sent it to me, but they do sell it in like 66 countries. So there's a good chance that if you just search like Tussock Jumper near me or search some of your local favorite stores, yeah, you're going to find this, or if not, some of the other ones that they have. So just kind of search around and you'll be able to find it. Let's go ahead and get started with the review. First of all, screw top, plus one. Whoa. Very, very solidly in their screw top. So South Africa is known for its Chenin Blanc. It's basically one of the signature grapes of South Africa. It has a really nice tropical note, it preserves the acid, and it's very fruit driven and pretty intense for the most part. I will say though, that it's not my favorite representation of the grape. My favorite representation of the grape comes out of Australia, because there's certain parts of Australia where you can get some screamingly high acid on that, and those Chenin Blancs will age for a really long time and develop some really nice tertiary. I honestly have not had some old South African Chenin, so it might actually do that, but most of the stuff that I've had from South Africa has tended to be a couple years old. It's hasn't had a chance to age too long. This is a 2020, so this is kind of on par with that. With that being said though, let's get to the color, and I need to get to it quickly because oh my gosh, that nose. From a color standpoint, you're a pale lemon, no artifacts, no cloudiness. All right, so, and I mentioned the nose. Pronounced intensity on the nose. I'm getting like, there's a good 6 inches right here, and I can get stuff out of this wine. This wine is very strong on the nose. Whew. So, ooh, pineapple. There's a little bit of red apple. It says guava. I'm not getting guava. I am getting like a bit of like a peach and like a cantaloupe. I'm also getting this note of, it's like a, oh, there's a little bit of pear in there, like green pear, but that's not what I'm getting. It's, ah, that's right. It smells like my, the tea that I drink sometimes to help me go to sleep. So it has a little bit of like a chamomile. Yeah, yeah. And it honestly smells like it's gonna be a little high in acid too, because it's kind of stinging on my nose a tiny bit. No noticeable detection of alcohol too. Now let's get to the taste. High acid. Oh my God, high acid. So, oh my God, really high acid, and it's off dry. It's not like really high acid and really bone dry like the stuff that I normally get. However, the flavor intensity on this is very pronounced. The body, medium minus body, low alcohol. The fruit and everything is really intense on the palate, but it has a medium minus finish. So it's there really, like a really strong presence, and then it goes away. And it almost goes away cleanly. The only thing that tends to hang on a little bit is that peach and pear. So it has this, like this medium body, and then it has this off dry, and then it has this screaming high acid with really intense fruit. And I would normally say that a wine like this is out of balance, but it actually really works. It works really, really well. This is a wine that you can pair with food, or it's a wine that you can just drink on its own, because it's strong enough to be a solo drinker, but also has enough character, and especially the acid, to pair well with food. I might be giving it away already with the way I'm kind of talking about it, but let's get to the blick. So in terms of balance, like I said, I think you're in balance, 1 point. Length, medium minus finish, no points. In terms of intensity, pronounced on the nose, pronounced on the palate, full point. And in terms of complexity, I am getting this like nice tea note. I'm getting multiple fruit. I'm not getting any sort of preparation in oak, and I'm not really getting any like secondary like mallow and stuff. But it's one of those things where it's rare that I actually find wine that is coming out of South Africa, specifically Chenin Blanc, that actually goes through a lot of secondary, a lot of kind of barrel type of aging. That's not typically what I find when I buy those wines. But you do have a good amount of complexity, and I don't expect tertiary in the 2020, so I'm gonna go ahead and give you half a point. In the end, that's 2.5 points. In the end, that's 2.5 points. So it could be good, or it could be very good. And here's how you're gonna be able to determine this. If you are someone who really likes those bright, high acid, zingy wines, it's a very good. If you are someone who doesn't like that as much, you want some more of those kind of well-rounded, maybe like tertiary developed Chenins, then this is not gonna be it for you. It's gonna be a good, it's just not gonna be very good, because you're not gonna get those honeyed notes and some of the other stuff you get as it ages. On this note, with for what it is, I'm gonna give it very good. I like it. I really like high acid wines, and I'm not disappointed by this whatsoever. As a matter of fact, I'm actually thinking that when I'm done doing this review, I'm gonna go downstairs and make some fish papillotes for dinner. So just get some barramundi and stick that on top of some spiralized vegetables. Make sure I season it really well. Add in some olive oil, and then also add in some of this wine as the liquid, and just kind of let it steam and all come together. And man, I think that'd be a really good use for this wine. Anyway, this has been Stuart with Wine on the Dime. If you liked today's video, please like, subscribe, and comment. Have you had the 2020 Tussock Jumper Chenin Blanc? I'd be interested to know if you have. Leave a comment below, and I'll see you all again soon with another episode from Wine on the Dime.